Bobby Jones was just our hero and our role model. At that time, of course, he was in his 20s, and we just thought everything he did was just right. And he was such a wonderful man. I mean, he just was a really fine Southern gentleman that everyone admired. Davis, he's just a very fine Southern gentleman too, just as Bob was. And everybody highly respects him here and has such nice manners and conducts himself so well on the golf course and other places as well. And everybody looks up to him, I think. And I certainly do.
For more than 25 years, Davis Love has performed his craft with grace and power.
Wonderful stroke by Davis Love.
Davis Love has won the Players' Championship.
It doesn't get any better than this.
He did it the hard way. It was a great golf shot.
That is what love is all about.
Yet, like Bob Jones, his golf prowess isn't what defines Davis Love as a person.
I think his happiest moments in many ways have been away from the golf course. He's really in his sweet spot when he's home in St. Simon Islands and he's free of those things that people expect of him and he can just be himself.
Unlike some other guys on the PGA Tour who retreat when they have weeks off, you know, go away, you know, their house might be under, you know, big time security. You know, Davis is not that type of guy. He's kind of out in the community and you see him a lot.
People are used to seeing him here. He grew up here. It's a small town. Everybody knows everybody. So it's a friendly place where he can relax and be at home.
You know, when he's here in town, he's usually swinging by the shop. He'll walk in with the t-shirt and flip-flops and he jumps behind the register. He always tells me, he says, don't let me ring anything up, but I can surely sell some stuff. As I tell him, he's a rock star, but he doesn't know that he's a rock star. He's just a normal guy.
That's unique for an icon in a sporting environment today where they want to be treated differently. You'll always see him in the community, talking to people, spending time with kids, big lover of family. And I think that's a big factor in why we're all here.
Everybody around Seattle and all the professional golfers call him Uncle Davis. He's known for his golf, but I think he's appreciated and liked for all the other things he does.
He's the guy that has really attracted all of us to St. Simons. I think that just speaks volumes as to his character and certainly what that area is about, the community. And as a result, we're one big family, and he's the uncle.
On any given weekend, if he's not playing golf and he's not hunting, you may find him in jeans, in his pickup truck, pulled up to Southern Soul Barbecue and enjoying a barbecue with everybody else on the island. He's no different than the rest of us on the island.
Usually he comes in camo.
Yeah, he doesn't talk golf. You don't talk golf with Davis. He wants to talk about barbecue. The man knows his barbecue.
If the line's out the door, he'll get in line with everyone else and stand right there with them. You just don't get any nicer than Davis, to be honest with you. You wish everybody was like Davis.
You do, you really do.
His life in full balance. Davis relishes the morals honed during his youth in a house full of love.
Davis has always been a fine young man. Of course, his dad was one of the finest men I've ever known. And I know how he raised Davis. Values right up front.
He was a modest guy and a thorough person and set very high standards. And he played the game very straight and he played his life in a very straight manner.
It's all part of growing up and being in an environment where you were expected to be respectful and unassuming, and he lived that kind of life.
Dad at Atlanta Country Club had a junior program that you had to learn those lessons before you were allowed to on the golf course as a young guy, whether you were the son of the golf pro or just a member's kid. So we learned that early on.
From principles absorbed off the course to lessons on it, Love's bond with his father matured.
There was a time there when Davis was a young adult when my dad said, all right, if you want to be serious about this, we got an instructor and student relationship, and we got a father-son relationship, we got to try to separate those. And they did a good job of doing that.
He and his dad were just inseparable. His dad watched him every minute he could. It's amazing the rapport between the two. It was a great father-son relationship, and they had great respect for each other.
He learned from his dad those years, you can't get too up and you can't get too down. And I think that's why he can put it all in perspective.
When I think back to the young man I met more than 25 years ago and the middle-aged man that I saw captaining the United States Ryder Cup team just a couple of months ago, he was a cordial and thoughtful man then, and he's a cordial and thoughtful man now. At the Ryder Cup, in the face of a very, very difficult defeat, he handled it with extreme dignity.
You know, playing for him last year on the Ryder Cup, never once saw Davis seem to take it hard. What happened out there, it was probably great for the game of golf. You know, it was a shame for our team. It was heartbreaking for our team. But Davis just could not have handled it with more class.
How he handled us and what he portrayed to us never wavered. I mean, it was always class. It was always high integrity. But that's Davis. As he said, we went there as a team, and we're going to win or lose as a team, and we're going to handle ourselves just like our captain.
Davis is a great role model for young players coming up to emulate in terms of how they handle themselves on the golf course and off the golf course, and sets a great standard for those coming behind him.
I've learned a lot from him and how he handles himself. Into my career, I would love to have a similar reputation that Davis has.
He knows how to handle, juggle, and balance golf with his personal life, his family. What I see is he's very giving. You know, he's very generous. He's very generous of his time and his energy.
Anybody he ever touches, he has an impact on them, and I think that's what Bobby Jones did, and I know that's what Davis Love is doing.
Been one of those guys that could not be more helpful. Can't go too much out of his way. If you ever need anything, you go to Davis, and he is there to help.
He has helped perpetuate the charitable culture on the PGA Tour. He believes in giving back. He believes in our tournaments giving back. On the board, he's been a big supporter of that. And in his own right, with the McGladrey Classic that his own foundation conducts in Sea Island, giving money to local charities.
If every community in America had a person like Davis Love, they would be extremely fortunate.
The mission of the Davis Love Foundation is to help charities that have to do with children and families in need, specifically Special Olympics, Boys and Girls Club of Southeast Georgia, and then a number of other local charities that we help through proceeds from the McGladrey Classic. In 3 short years, we've raised almost $1 million for charity.
Davis and his family have been very generous to the Boys and Girls Club and in the Team Center for many years. We went to Davis and asked if he could be involved and if we could use his name, but it turned out we got his name, his family, his support. It just turned out to be more than we ever asked for.
We serve over 3,600 kids, and we have 8 centers for those 3,600 kids, and it's hard to get those kids from one place to another after school. So with the McGladrey Classic and with their generosity, they have given us $250,000, where we've been fortunate enough to purchase buses and transport our kids to our centers.
He's given so much to this organization, and I think if he didn't, we all wouldn't be at the standpoint we are right now.
Somebody that high up in the world to actually want to help out and like donate money and equipment and stuff to help us out here, it's actually an honor.
When he comes here, he shows us that we can actually make it out there. If we do become famous, we can come back to our community and help out just like Davis Love did.
The comparisons are unmistakable. Two gentlemen from Atlanta, bound by their ethics, by their sportsmanship, and by using golf as a pathway for greater causes.
Bob Jones is the kind of man that Davis Love emulated, and I think everybody who idealizes Bob Jones sees Davis Love in Bob Jones.
Davis has done the right thing about golf. He has been the right kind of person to carry the spirit of the game forward.
People that win this Jones Award kind of set a standard for the game of golf, for the integrity that is around the game of golf, and Davis is a very good one to receive the award.
I've never come across a guy with greater class or the manner in which he plays the game. There's nobody that I can think of that is more deserving than Davis Love III.
I knew Davis Love Jr. Davis III has been a true gentleman and has represented the game of golf so wonderfully well. And couldn't happen to a better guy.
Knowing that he won that award just makes me even more appreciative for how great of a dad he is and the life lessons he's taught me on the golf course and off the golf course.
We always told our boys, and when they were out on their own, we were more proud of who they were than what they were doing. And for Davis to be honored for that, that's very special.
Bobby Jones did have a special place in my dad's heart. Growing up, he was the guy that we sort of emulated as our idol, and he was such a true sportsman. Just the grace that he won with and that he lost with, and I think that certainly helped to define Davis. The fact that that's the man, the character that he's developed, Dad would be very proud.